This was a thrift store find. It is an Emerson EVC1595 digital multi-system video converter. It can accept signals in NTSC, PAL, or SECAM format. It shows the various countries each system is used in. And it can also automatically detect each system, but you can also switch it into manual mode. It's a fairly large cabinet. It's about the size of a more modern VCR. And it's quite heavy too. It's a metal cabinet. On the bottom it has circular feet with gold trim, so it's clearly styled to look like an audio-visual component. It has these sort of fake wood sides. On the back has your serial number sticker. It says 15 volts DC, but I'm using a 10 volt DC Sega Genesis power supply and it works just fine. Here's the video input for composite video only. And here's the manual and automatic switch. So if you put it in manual, you can choose between PAL, SECAM, NTSC 4.43, which is used by European VCRs to play American tapes on PAL televisions, and regular NTSC. Here's the video output and the switch for the output to go between PAL and NTSC. It cannot output SECAM video. So when I turn it on in automatic mode, you can see the LEDs cycling because it's trying to automatically detect the input signal. If I switch into manual mode, then you can move the switch on the back and you'll see the indication of which system it's set to. I'll set it back to automatic. And if I connect the signal source, you can see it detected it as an NTSC signal. It's coming from this camcorder here, and it's going out to the TV here. So right now it's not converting anything. Now if I set the output to PAL, you can see the TV goes to black and white, and it has some flickering lines on it, because this is not a multi-system TV. Unlike most flat panel TVs, it's only designed for NTSC. So I'll switch it back, and now it works correctly. Now if I switch into manual mode, and tell it I'm feeding it with a PAL signal, you can see the bottom of the screen becomes garbage, because it's expecting to get a 625 line PAL signal, and it's only getting 525 lines, so the extra 100 lines are showing up as garbage. Now if I switch it to NTSC 4.43, it's not showing up as color because the frequency of the color subcarrier is different. But if I switch back to regular NTSC, it works fine. And here's another camcorder which actually can produce a PAL video output, so I'll switch it to PAL. So now it's set to PAL. And I'll hook up the video output of this to the input of the converter. Well, I had to switch to my old CRT television when trying to convert the PAL signal to NTSC using this thing, because the flat panel one had a bunch of horizontal lines on it for some reason. I don't know, it could be just this is not putting out a very good quality signal, because this is a rather cheap little camcorder. But it is putting out a PAL video signal into the converter. So you can see it detected it as PAL. And here's the output on the TV. I think the flickering is just because PAL is a 50 hertz refresh rate. And I have this big fluorescent light flickering at 60 hertz. So it does create some flickering due to the difference in the frequencies. If I switch this to PAL output, you can see it doesn't work at all because it can't lock onto the 50 hertz refresh rate. And if I go through the camcorder's menu to switch it back to NTSC output, let's see how quickly it readjusts. Okay, that was pretty quick. One thing to keep in mind with these video signal format converters is that it will not let you play European PAL videotapes on an American VCR or vice versa. You will still need a VCR that matches the format of the tape you're trying to play, but this will let you convert the output of the VCR into whatever format you need. Of course, this video wouldn't be complete if I didn't take it apart to show you what's inside. There's two separate circuit boards. It looks like all the analog circuitry is on this board, and all the digital circuitry is on this board. I'm sure it uses a frame buffer to hold each video frame in memory as it does the conversion. It has a few surface mount chips, all made by Sony. There's a date code of 9933 upside down there, so it's from 1999. A whole bunch of capacitors there. And EEV blog would love this. He would call it a bodge. It's when they have to change the circuitry after the circuit board is printed in order to make it work right. You can see a couple resistors and a capacitor just soldered to each other on top of the chip there, even a little diode there. So obviously they had to redo that part of the circuitry to get it to work right. There are some trimmers here to adjust it, but I don't have the service manual, so I'm not going to fool around with those. So it's quite complex.